Hello friends, this is Shravan. This is my YouTube channel, Civil Engineering Tutorial by Shravan. To subscribe my channel, click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates.
In this video lecture, I will explain you analysis and designing of staircases by using StatPro V8A software. Go to StatPro V8A software. Click on new project, select space, give the structure name. Just I am assuming the structure name as SSS. So save your file location. Just I am saving my file location to desktop. Staircases design, click on OK. So here we need to select the length units in meter as well as force units in kilonewton as per IS code. Click on next button, click on finish button. So after that we need to keep the structure in front of you. For the respect to staircases, just I am assuming the 0.3 is my rising height and 0.3 is my landing width. So and the landing slab will be consisting of 1.2 meter width. So for the creation of 0.3 meter rising and 0.3 creation of landing, this we need to create the grid lines. So here I was observed that the grid lines will be consisting of 1 meter width in x direction and y direction. Just we need to change that grid lines to 0.3 and 0.3 in x direction as well as y direction. So for that go to edit button. So here we need to edit the spacing. Just I am assuming the spacing as 0.3 meter and spacing in y direction as 0.3. Click on OK. So after that we need to create the staircases. So for that just I am assuming 0, 0 is my starting point. 0.3, 0.3, 0.6, 0.6, 0.9, 0.9, 0.1.2, 1.2, 1.5, 1.5 and 1.8, 1.8, 2.1, 2.1. So after that we need to create the landing width. So landing width will be consisting of 0.3, 0.3, 0.3. Total will be 0.9. So go to select your starting point and select your ending point. After that we need to create the replicate for the respective staircases. So for that just I am selecting my staircases. Only riser as well as landing for the respective staircases. Go to replicate button in y direction. Just we need to assume the spacing. Just I am assuming the spacing will be consisting of 1.2 meter. Click on link steps. So minus 1.2. Why? Because this replicate is going to minus y direction. Click on OK. So after that keep your structure in 3D view again. So it will create your staircases like this. So after that we need to add the slab section for this respective landing. So for that go to click on your node cursor. Just select your node. Just I am selecting my node. Click on copy. Just we need to paste the node which is at a distance of 0.9 in x direction. Click on OK. So after that we need to add the beam cursor for the respective nodes. Go to select your beam cursor. Just add your beam cursor. Just I am adding my beam cursor. So after that we need to copy the respective frame member to 1.2 plus 1.2, nothing but 2.4 meter in z direction, minus z direction. So further go to your replicate button again, z direction again, one step, minus 2.4 is my distance. Click on link steps again, click on OK. So it will create your landing. Just I am deleting beam at the center. Just click on delete button. Yes. So after that we need to create the staircases in this direction also. So after that we need to draw the staircases in this direction. So for that we need to edit the grids initially. Just I am going to edit button. So we need to edit the grids in y direction. Just I am assuming 15 grids are there in y direction. Click on OK. After that keep your structure in 3D view. Just we need to copy the respective node point to y direction. Go to select your node cursor. Just select your nodes. Go to copy. Paste nodes which is at a distance of y direction of 0.3. Click on OK. So after that keep your structure in front of you. Again we need to select the snap node grid. Again we need to draw the beam for the respective stair. Again just I am drawing my beams in a similar way. So after that keep your structure in 3D view again. Again we need to copy this respective stairs to 1.2 meter in this direction. So for that keep your structure in front of you again. Again select your riser as well as landing for the respective stairs. Go to your replicate in z direction. Number of steps is 1. Each step will be consisting of minus 1.2. Click on link steps. Click on OK. So after that I will show you this model in 3D view. So this is my staircases. So it will be consisting of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 number of stairs in up to landing height. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 number of stairs are there for the slab. So after that we need to create the slab members, nothing but plate members for the respective staircases. So for that keep your structure in front of you. Initially I will create the plate members for the bottom stairs. So after that I will create the member for member sections for the respective landing. Go to cut section command. Initially go to selective view, click on OK. cut the bottom portion of your respective stays. Just I'm cutting my bottom portion. So after that, we need to create the member sections for the rest of this. So go to add your 4 node plate. Just I am adding 4 node plate for the respective staircases. So after that, click on hold structure command again. Again, we need to select the 4 node plate for the respective landing slab. Go to select your first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point. Again, select your first node point, second, third, fourth. Again, select first, second, third, fourth. Select your first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point. First node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point. Click on first node point again, select second node point again, third node point again, fourth node point again, first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point, select your first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point, select your first node point, second, third, fourth, 1, 2, 3, 4. So select your 1, 2, 3, 4. So I was created the slab members for the respective staircases. So after that, I will show you this model in 3D view. So click on 3D rendering view for the respective stairs. So this is my stairs. So it will be consisting of 0.3 meter landing as well as 0.3 meter riser. And so this landing slab will be consisting of 0.9 meter width and length will be consisting of 2.4 meter. So after that, we need to add the properties for the respective staircases. For that, go to general, click on properties, go to define your thickness for the respective slab. Just I am assuming the thickness will be consisting of 0.12. click on add. So go to close. Again, we need to create the dimensions for the respective beam. Click on define. So click on rectangular section. Just I am assuming the rectangular section will be consisting of 0.05 meter in YD direction as well as ZD direction. Click on add, click on close. So after that, select your plate thickness, click on assign to view, assign, yes. So after that, select your 0.05, click on assign to view, assign, yes. So I will show you this model in 3D rendering view again. So click on 3D rendering view for the respective stair. So this is my stair. So it will be consisting of 0.12 is my thickness for the respective slab and 0.05 is my respective thickness for the beam section. So we need to apply the load cases and support reactions for the respective stair. So for that, go to supports. So here we need to create the fixed support for the respective staircases. Click on add button, select your support tool. Just we need to select the node point. So where we need to apply the fixed support for the respective stairs. Just I'm selecting my node points. So rotate your structure, just select your node points, click on select assign to selected nodes, click on assign, yes. So after that, we need to apply the load cases for the respective staircases. Go to load case definition, click on add, click on add your load cases. Just I am assuming the dead load for the respective staircases initially. So after that, we need to assume the live load for the respective staircase. Just I am assuming the live load, click on add. So click on close button. So here we need to select the dead load, click on add button. So we need to add the self weight for the respective staircases. So after that, we need to add the live load for the respective stair, click on add. Go to your plate load. Just we need to apply the plate pressure on full plate. So just I'm assuming -2.5 is my intensity, so which is acting in ZY direction. Click on add, close. Go to select your self weight, click on assign to view, assign, yes. So after that, select your live load, click on assign to view, assign, yes. So after that, go to your analysis and print, add your no print, close it. Again, go to analyze, run analysis, save it. So here we need to check for the zero errors for the respective stair. So here my model is checked with zero errors, zero warnings, zero notes. Go to post to processing mode, click on done button, apply your load cases. Just I'm applying my load cases as dead load as well as live load. Click on OK. So this is the deflection diagram for the respective stair. So by using control button, we can see the deflection for the respective stair. So after that, I will show you the bending moment diagram as well as shear force diagram for the respective stair. Go to select, deselect your deflection diagram, select your FY. So this is the shear force diagram for the respective stair. So after that, click on MZ. So this is the bending moment diagram for the respective staircases. So after that you go to your plate cursor. So go to select your plate, click on apply your maximum absolute pressure on plate, click on apply, click on OK. So this is the maximum absolute pressure for the respective stair. So after that we need to design the staircases. Go to modeling, click on design. So go to concrete design. So here we need to add the IS456. So go to select parameters. Initially we need to deselect all the selected parameters. Select your FC compressed strength, yield strength of shear reinforcement. Click on OK. Click on define parameters. So just I'm assuming the parameter will be consisting of M30 grade concrete. Click on add. Again select your FY main. So FY main will be consisting of 550 grade. Add it. Again go to select your FI section reinforcement 550,000. Click on add, close. Again go to define commands. Go to select your beam cursor. Click on add. Go to select your slab thickness. Click on add. Again you select your takeoff. Click on add, close. So here we need to assign the question mark for the respective staircase. Go to select your FI. Click on assign to view. Assign, yes. Go to select your FI main. Click on assign to view. Assign, yes. Again go to select section reinforcement. Assign to view. Assign, yes. Again select your beam cursor. Click on assign to view. Assign, yes. Again go to select your concrete element thickness. Click on assign to view. Assign, yes. So after that again go to analysis and print. Add your no print again. Again close it. Again go to analyze. Run analysis. Save it. Again we need to check for the zero errors for the respective model. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observing zero errors. Click on post to processing mode again. Click on done button again. So again we need to deselect the deflection diagram. So select your beam cursor. So select any one of the beam. So it will show your deflection values, shear bending values, loading. So after that select any one of the slab sections by using slab cursor. Select your plate, double click on it. It will show you the property constant, center stresses, corner stresses. So go to cancel this, go to output file, click on output file, click on concrete design. So it will show you the beam design results as well as a plate member design results for the respective staircases. So this is the process analysis and designing of staircases by using StatPro V8i software. Thank you.